Good evening, and welcome to the graduation of the class of 2020 at the Claire and Emmanuel G. Rosenblatt High School at Donna Klein Jewish Academy.
Thank you.
join seniors Daniela Supavitz and Ilanit Berkauer in the singing of the Star Spangled Banner and Hatikva.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight. Oh, the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streamed, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof to the night that our flag was still bare. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave for the land of the free and the home of the
welcome, Rabbi Marshall Lisak, principal of Rosenblatt High School.
Good evening, Erev Tov and Mazal Tov. My name is Rabbi Marshall Lisak, and I have the honor to serve as the principal of the Claire and Emmanuel G. Rosenblatt High School at Donna Klein Jewish Academy. Welcome to this unique and historic graduation ceremony as we celebrate the class of 2020. This truly is a moment in time. For us as a school community, it is as much unusual as it is inspiring. In a time of great uncertainty and pain for many, we are grateful that we're able to come together in our drive-in format to highlight this year's senior class and to send them on their way with love, well wishes, prayers for health, happiness, and greatness. In a typical year, I would now ask you to silence your cell phones. However, since you will be in your cars tonight for the event, I will hold off on that request. Instead, please follow the rules that we have put in place to minimize risk, keep everyone safe, and make as many people comfortable with tonight's ceremony as we can. Unless requested otherwise, or you need to use the restroom, please stay in your cars at all times. If you do need to leave your car, please wear a mask. Additionally, please stay in the car in which you arrived with your family and remain in your designated spot for the duration of tonight's program. Tonight's event marks the graduation of our 19th class in the history of the high school. Mazal Tov to our school community on this achievement, and most importantly to our students and their families. To the parents of these creative, vibrant, and talented young people, thank you for entrusting us with your children over these many years. Thank you to our Board of Trustees, our administration, our faculty, our staff, and our alumni. Your combined efforts and devotion to our community is extraordinary. Tonight would not be possible without the hard work and dedication of numerous members of the high school and the larger school team. I would like to specifically recognize Alana Joseph, Silvana Delbo, Silvina Chimaritsky, Scott Ball, and Elena Levine for their partnership, imagination, and dedication to thinking outside the box and providing for this year's seniors a meaningful and memorable graduation. Additionally, I want to thank Anita Schwartz and Alana Rubinstein for helping to make this event special in ways big and small. A special thank you to the Jewish Federation of South Palm Beach County, to Tom Ferlenza, Kevin Holland, Matt Levin, and their whole team for working with us to make graduation in person possible. To the Federation community, thank you for your partnership and your ongoing support of our school and our mission. As we celebrate the class of 2020, I want to share a few words with you. You are a group with immense talent, diverse interests, and amazing potential. You will be headed to outstanding universities here and in Israel, ready to learn, to get involved, and to give back. Instilled with the values of this school and the values of our people, we look with excitement to your leadership as graduates of Rosenblatt High School and Donna Klein Jewish Academy. We also want to recognize two of our seniors who will be joining the IDF and protecting Israel and the Jewish people. Danielle Chacham and Lee Dehoa, thank you for your service. May Hashem watch over you and keep you safe. Over the past 4 years, all of you, the class of 2020, have grown and matured. You have learned what it means to work hard, to taste success and experience defeat, to grow as friends and find your own path along the way. Some days were great while others were challenging, but you have pushed through, and tonight your reward is this graduation and the multitude of memories that you can carry with you as you move forward. We pray that the ideals and the values of our community have become part of who you are, and that they will serve as a guide for you in the communities in which you will soon reside. To our parents, we value the dedication and commitment of all parents who recognize the importance of a DKJA education. As we graduate the class of 2020, we know that we cannot reach this moment without you as our partners. We also want to specifically recognize those parents who have sent all of their children to our high school and are graduating their youngest child from DKJA tonight. The Dehoa family, the Elkarit family, the Goodis family, the Kadish family, the Manella family, and the Sapovitz family. In honor of the parents of all of our graduates, would all of you in attendance please honk your horns? We are also fortunate to have many students who have achieved the honorary title of DKJA Lifers. These students have attended DKJA since kindergarten or first grade, and they include Rennie Alvarez-Smith, Leah Bard, Danielle Chacham, Lee Dehoa, Dekel Dehoa, Gil Elkarif, Shayna Goodis, Jonah Manella, Danny Siemens, Daniela Sapovitz, and Ben Zuner. Please honk your horns in honor of these graduates. To tonight's graduates, we are well aware that your senior year did not end as planned. And although we carried hope that maybe, just maybe, some of those last senior moments, the ones that are a hallmark of a high school experience, could be made, but the realities of our time did not allow for this ending. So when you look back on your careers here in our school and the ending that none of us imagined, it should give you pause to ask yourselves, what did I learn from my time here and from these last few months in particular? I believe that there's not a single word that encapsulates the learning and the takeaways from these last few months. As such, I want to offer a variety of them. Flexibility, perseverance, adaptability, gratitude, perspective, hope. A quote I came across recently, often attributed to Mark Twain, goes as follows. History doesn't repeat itself, but it often rhymes. Although this moment in time is unique in its own nature, people have been responding to difficult circumstances and complex situations from time immemorial. Many say that it is in challenging situations that a person is really tested, and when their true character shines through. As a Jewish people, we look to our past to inform our present and to guide us towards the future. Our own history, full of challenges and accomplishments, offers a window into the soul of humankind and the great potential of human beings when faced with adversity in their lives. After many years in slavery in Egypt, the Israelites cry out to Hashem, essentially taking their future into their own hands and beginning the process of redemption. Their rising up leads to the freedom and to the formation of the Jewish people. In 70 CE, the Second Temple was destroyed. The Judaism, which everyone knew, centered around the temple, the sacrifices, and the biblical way of life, was no longer. And so the rabbis of that period adapted and soon developed a newer form of Judaism, an evolved form, some may say. And in so doing, they saved the Jewish religion. It is this form of Judaism, rabbinic Judaism, that we all practice today. In the Middle Ages, all across Europe, the Jewish people knew of the Crusades, of persecution, and of expulsions. And yet, when we study this period of Jewish history, this is the same time period when major Jewish learning centers were established in multiple places across Europe, when Jewish literature and poetry began to flourish, when rabbinic leaders and intellectuals rose to greatness, Maimonides, Rashi, and others. All of this, all of these accomplishments against the backdrop of uneasy times. And our modern era is no different. Against a history of anti-Semitism, Herzl developed a renewed vision for a Jewish future. From the ashes of the Holocaust rose a Jewish state. Einstein left Europe and that which he knew, and yet is forever linked to intellectual greatness. Ben-Gurion left Poland, fled his family, and became the prime minister of the state of Israel. And in an America that once limited Jewish involvement in organizations, industries, and universities, our people have made enormous contributions across society and are an integral part of the fabric of this great country. There is an idea in rabbinic thought that the rabbis of any current generation stand on the shoulders of the rabbis of the previous generation. Giants, they are called. One way to understand this concept is to say that those of a previous generation were greater than those of the current one. But another way to think about this idea and to apply it to the current experience of our own lives is to recognize that we have a lot to learn and a lot to gain from paying attention to our past. Your future is ahead of you, but you are blessed to be part of a people with a rich and inspiring past that can help to guide you through even what seem to be the most difficult of times or the most challenging of circumstances. Look to our history to give you hope for your future. Look to our history to give you guidance when a struggle is in front of you. Look to our history when you are unsure if you can overcome that next challenge. Look to our history as you plot your next steps in life. History doesn't repeat itself, but it often rhymes. You are the descendants of giants. Look to our history for that guidance, and giants you shall become. Mazal Tov to you, the class of 2020. We are so proud of all of you.
Congratulations to the class of many, many.
We
are so proud of you.
It's time to spread your wings and fly. Mazal Tov, you did it.
וביניהם תשובה לכל השאלות. יש אלוהים אחד גדול, ובעולם הזה נותן לנו הכל. בין אפלה לקרן אור, את הנתיב אנחנו רק צריכים לבחור. וזה ידוע, חיים הם מתנה, הכל צפוי והרשות נתונה. מי שמאמין לא מפחד, את האמונה לאבד, ולנו יש את מלך העולם, והוא שומר אותנו מכולם. מי שמאמין לא מפחד, את האמונה לאבד, ולנו יש את מלך העולם, והוא שומר אותנו מכולם.
אשרינו
העם הזה ומשפחה, אחד ועוד אחד זה סוד ההצלחה. עם ישראל לא יוותר, תמיד על המפה אנחנו נשאר. וזה ידוע, חיים הם מתנה, הכל צפוי והרשות נתונה. מי שמאמין לא מפחד, את האמונה לאבד, ולנו יש את מלך העולם, והוא שומר אותנו מכולם. מי שמאמין לא מפחד, את האמונה לאבד, ולנו יש את מלך העולם, והוא שומר אותנו
Smith.
Hi, my name is Remy Alvarez Smith, and this is my 13th year here at Donna Klein Jewish Academy. Although this year did not go quite as planned, I cannot forget the other 12 remarkable years DKJ has given me. From the kindergarten plan, which I still remember my three lines, to the 8th grade Israel trip where I visited and fell in love with Israel for the first time, to my last Shal Maton as a Roosevelt High School senior, Donna Klein has made a lasting and unforgettable impact on my life. DKJ has also given me many opportunities, like finding my passion and love for for my career choice of nursing through the pre-med club, which I am forever grateful for. It has also led me to my best friends for life that I don't know what I'm going to do without next year. Although some years were more challenging than others, I cannot have done it without the people who guided me to where I am today. Dr. Recibo, thank you for always believing me and telling me I can do it. Your help with the ACT and my college essay was immense, and I am forever appreciative of it. I truly cannot have done it without you. A big thank you to Mrs. Joseph for putting up with our grade and always doing her best for us, even when we were out of dress code or had something to complain about. Also, thank you for really waking me up every morning by telling us to go to Tefillah after first period every single day. Thank you to all the other teachers and faculty who put up with me, especially when sitting next to or across from my friends. But just as an FYI, moving my seat does absolutely nothing because I always will find someone to talk to or just get my friends' attention from across the room. And to the queen herself, Miss Selma. Thank you for being a second mom, therapist, and friend all in one. You've honestly made my high school experience, and I'm going to miss you so much. Thank you for always having your office and arms open for any crazy story or rant I need to tell you, or when I just don't want to be in class, even when you have a ton of work to do or get in trouble for having us in here. Thank you for giving the best advice, always fighting for us, and of course, all the lollipops. Expect many phone calls and visits next year. Last but certainly not least, Mom. Thank you for absolutely everything. Thank you for always believing in me and being my rock. Thank you for giving Ari and me the best life and showing us how to conquer every challenge in it with the best attitude possible. I and my friends really don't know what I'm going to do without you and your lunches and vitamins every day next year. I love you so much. To the class of 2021, first, whatever you do, do not make TikToks at or during school. Been there, done that. Appreciate every day and moment you have with your friends, because as much as you want it to be over and graduate already and not do any more busy work that the teachers love to give, the year goes by so fast, and before you know it, you will be in this moment not wanting to leave your best friends and the past 4 years of your life. Although this is a bittersweet moment and transition, I am beyond excited and cannot wait to begin my education and the next chapter of my life at the University of Miami. Go Canes!
Leah Bard.
Miss Levine, Rabbi Lisa, Miss Joseph, faculty, staff, fellow classmates, and members of the community, my name is Leah Bard, and I am going to share a quote with you that I live by. What wisdom can you find that is greater than kindness? At a very young age, I developed a belief that a person's character is based upon three things. Do they go through life with good morals and values? Are they willing to give back to those around them? And do they have a thirst for knowledge? Throughout your entire lifetime, your character is constantly evolving. Donna Klein Jewish Academy, my second home since kindergarten, has been a significant factor in shaping who I am today. Compassion of others, holding the highest integrity, and showing gratitude to those around me, and having respect are four of the most important responsibilities that I have carried with me throughout my years at Donna Klein. While teaching academics is important, morality is something that the school encompasses into daily learning as a vital part of their curriculum. Throughout all of my years at DKJA, I have continuously learned morals and values that I will take with me for the rest of my life. In 2013, Colorado experienced disastrous flooding. I will never forget sitting in Judaics class and watching a video of the devastation. I have always been taught in and out of school to give back to people in need, so I immediately thought to myself, what can I do to help? With the support of DKJA, I started a community and school-wide collection of donations that I shipped to a nonprofit organization in Colorado. This was the start of my everlasting passion for community service. It started right here at Donna Klein Jewish Academy. I have a dear friend, Martin, who lives on our campus in Sinai Residences. He has been a role model to me for the past 3 years. Martin suffers from visual impairment. Once a week, I visit him, and our time together is filled with meaningful conversations good laughs, and plentiful advice. I want to thank you, Martin, for empowering me to never give up. I'm so thankful for our friendship. The bonds I have formed through my service, whether it be spending quality time with my special needs friend Kaya, or volunteering every Monday at the Falk Center for Psychology in a discussion group with senior citizens, are priceless. Community service is ingrained in me, and I will never stop giving. My desire to learn new things and love of learning has been a motivation behind all of my hard work throughout my years at Donna Klein. I am proud to announce that I will be attending my dream school, Tulane University, in New Orleans this fall. There are so many people who have been by my side throughout this whole journey, and each and every one of you holds a special place in my heart. Moore and Miriam, I truly look up to your passion for Zionism, Judaism, and mindfulness. You are an inspiration to me and have inspired me to continue studying about Judaism and Zionism in college. Rabbi Lisa, Ms. Joseph, Ms. Neumann, and Ms. Delva, thank you for always giving me opportunities and finding the best in me. Ms. Granvin, I can't thank you enough for always believing in me and giving me your constant support and guidance. I will miss our time together. Nunny, thank you for your endless love and encouragement. I wish you were here to celebrate with us, and I can't wait to see you soon. To my best friend and brother Noah, thank you for always being there for me. We will have to have our late night talks through FaceTime next year. I know that I can count on you for everything. Mom and Dad, you immigrated from South Africa to give me the best life possible. Your sacrifice was worth it. Thank you for never leaving my side and always pushing me to do my best. To my fellow classmates, I wish you all success and happiness in your future endeavors. I don't think my college classes will be as entertaining without you guys. Thank you for the memories. Look out, world. Here I come, rolling.
Ilanit Burkhauer.
From my first day as a new student at Donna Klein in 9th grade, I knew I was in a special academic and social environment. I learned to appreciate every gift that my high school has given me. Sitting in isolation for the last 2 months of high school, yet still feeling the love and support from my community of teachers, counselors, and friends have guided me through this time and have given me lots of opportunity to contemplate on the rare exceptional environment that I have been studying for the past 4 years. I have learned about working within a structured environment, but showing resilience when things don't go as planned. Donna Klein is a community which allowed me to grow in knowledge, expand my horizons, and help me determine my next steps of what I hope to accomplish, as well as support my strong Jewish identity. I would like to thank my teachers for believing in me, encouraging me, motivating me, and pushing me to step out of my comfort zone. My experiences at Donna Klein have helped me realize that I can succeed in anything that I set my mind to. Thank you to Ms. Feingold for presenting me with so many wonderful opportunities in the field of medicine and for your continuous support and pushing me to achieve my goals during my high school year. And thank you to Ms. Bleakwoods for always being there for your daily positive and loud energy at 2:30 p.m. and for holding me up to the high standards. I'd also like to thank Mrs. Joseph for her mentorship as a teacher and role model and for the love that you have shown us and inspired us to perform our very best. Lastly, thank you, Mom and Dad, for being there for me every day and encouraging me to always do my best in school and life no matter the challenges in front of you. Thank you for believing in me every step of the way and doing everything you can possible to help me succeed. I couldn't have done this without you guys. For the graduating class of 2021, in the best way possible, I am wishing you an uneventful senior year. Enjoy every moment as it lasts.
Sam Bernstein.
Hello, I'm Sam Bernstein, and I started here at Donna Klein in 5th grade. As I look back on my 8 years at the school, I now realize how special this community is. Now, I say community because Donna Klein Jewish Academy is much more than a place of academia. As the whole world has been affected by COVID-19, the last few months have been turbulent, to say the least. Yet, I still feel the energy of the RHS circular hallways every day. I was reassured by this community spirit, as just the other day I opened my front door to the tune of Pomp and Circumstance and was cheered on by Miss Delvo, Ms. Joseph, Rabbi Lisak, Ms. Levine, and Alana Rubenstein. Every day of these past 8 years has been a blessing for me, but there have definitely been some highlights that I would like to share, including playing on the middle school baseball team, going to Israel in eighth grade, being on the mock trial team for 4 years of high school, and getting to perform at three coffee houses. And most importantly, bringing back the music to RHS with a revival of the RHS band. We still never came up with a clever name. All these moments now are memories, but looking back, I know that I've made the best of my time here, part of this awesome community. I would like to congratulate the 2020 senior class on this milestone accomplishment, and I wish all you the best of luck in the next chapters of your life, wherever that may be. I would also like to thank all of my teachers for their amazing support and dedication over the past 4 years. I'm constantly inspired every day by the Donna Klein faculty who always go the extra mile for their students. Thank you, teachers. I would especially like to thank one teacher, Miriam Klein, for believing me in my sophomore year and guiding me to become a contributor to the mock trial team. I'm forever grateful for this experience I had the past 3 years and for all the life skills I learned along the way. Finally, I'd like to thank my family. To my sister, Esther, thank you for putting up with me on our daily car rides to and from school. To my brother, Noam, thank you for your constant kindness, and I'm so grateful for how close we've become in the last couple of years. To my mom and dad, who work tirelessly every day to allow me to attend such a wonderful school. Mom and Dad, I love you very much and I will miss you come fall. In the fall, I will be heading up the road to Orlando, where I will be attending the University of Central Florida, where I hope to enter the field of nursing as I've been inspired by the incredible medical professionals these past 3 months. Go Knights and charge on.
Noah Bookstein.
Hello, my name is Noah Bookstein. First, I would like to start off by congratulating this year's class of 2020. I think it's safe to say that these last couple of months have been strange and challenging for everyone. I'm glad that we were all able to make it here today, because for a while it looked like this celebration might not have taken place. As I was writing this speech and reflecting on the many changes I have seen in the world, as well as the massive changes in my own life over the last year, I realized that one thing did not change. I still wrote and submitted the first draft of this speech at the last minute, even with a week-long extension and a global pandemic to give me all the time in the world to have done this earlier. I've decided to take a different approach here, so many of the words come from the lyrics of my favorite band, the Beatles. This decision was made mainly because if I hear somebody didn't like my speech tonight, I can refer them to Paul McCartney. As I begin the next chapter in my life, there are places I remember. From Mount Sinai Hospital in New York City, where I was born, Eisner Camp, Massachusetts, Carmel Academy in Connecticut, and more recently, Donna Klein Jewish Academy here in Florida. When I moved from New York and started in eighth grade, it wasn't easy living in a new place and having to start over. But soon, I got by with a little help from my friends, who I am very thankful for. To my parents, the rest of my family, I do appreciate you being around. Through pools of sorrow and waves of joy, you have all been there for me. Even when my thoughts meander like a restless wind inside a letterbox, and I seem like a real nowhere man sitting in his nowhere land, you never fail to help me get my feet back on the ground. If not for you, my sky would fall, rain would gather too. Without your love, I'd be nowhere at all. I'd be lost if not for you. To my teachers, I am forever in your debt. I can always rely on you to give me some truth in a world so full of misinformation. I would like to thank you all for taking these sunken eyes and teaching them to see. I would like to thank Mrs. Neumann for helping me navigate the long and winding road that high school can be, Mrs. Rothman for her words of wisdom on the college process, and a special thank you to Mrs. Grandigan for reminding me that no matter how hard things get and how disorganized I become, we can work it out. Lastly, for the junior class who is here today, I would like to remind you, and everyone else for that matter, life is very short and there's no time for fussing and fighting, my friend, so give peace a chance.
Please welcome the CEO of the Jewish National Fund, Russell Robinson, who will now share a few words for the class of 2020.
Thank you for the honor of addressing the class of 2020 of the Claire and Emmanuel G. Rosenblatt High School at the Donna Klein Jewish Academy. 23 seniors, three of which are going on to the Israel Defense Forces, others on gap year programs, and others to universities across America. All of you to the next stages of your life. As Chief Executive Officer of Jewish National Fund, congratulations for the over 600,000 donors and millions who are part of our programs in Israel, the land of the Jewish people. Shana Goodis, thank you for being this year's Jewish National Fund Club President. Thank you all, because every year you assisted us during our Winter Connection, collecting more than just pledge cards. You help others to participate in one of the most important traditions of Jewish life, tzedakah. You help build the land of Israel for the Jewish people everywhere. Now I know these are defining moments we are living in today, yet you will have defining moments throughout your life. Your connection to Israel and to Judaism, your love and respect and the values you've learned at school will help you throughout life and strengthen our community and guarantee our future, your future. You'll have defining moments that will come in simple acts that I guarantee that if you do the right thing and are proud of who you are as a Jew and proud of what we are doing as a people with enthusiasm, with passion, you will change the world. Now, the beautiful thing about tzedakah and contributing is that it's not just about giving money, it's about finding others to join you. Don't ever stop contributing. Don't ever stop asking people to participate. Respect everyone, because we as a Jewish people have proven to the world that we are some of the best. It is Israel, the only nation on the face of the earth, which brought black people in as citizens, not as slaves. Israel brought 87,000 Ethiopians to become citizens of the land of Israel, and this week 3,000 more Ethiopian Jews will be reunited to the land of the Jewish people, Israel. During your life, you will find that there is not perfection. There's not perfection in Israel, and there's for sure not perfection with us as human beings. Yet everyone in Israel and the Jewish people want to be better. Be part of Israel in your actions in life. Israel wants to make the world a better place and needs you. She is a nation still under creation, and we get to participate. That's what we do every day at Jewish National Fund, is to allow people to participate in this miracle. It is our miracle. It is your miracle. During your graduation, I know that you're going to be singing HaTikvah. I want you to think about those words today as you move forward with your life. HaTikvah, a song of hope, a song of 2,000 years of hope of returning to the land of Israel, restoring it and reclaiming it. As long as there is tears from our eyes, our hope is never lost. As long as there is blood in our veins, our hope is never lost. Go, my people, in peace. Our hope is not lost. 23 graduating seniors. Our hope is not lost.
Tonight's graduation would not be complete if we didn't acknowledge and honor the real-life heroes in our nation right now. Please, take a moment to salute and thank all of the essential frontline workers for their endless service, selflessness, and sacrifice. So many are here with us tonight as well, so please, everyone, honk your horns and flash your lights to thank these modern-day heroes. Danielle Chacham.
All these years, I've always dreamt of this day where I would finally graduate high school and move on to the next chapter in my life.
but as I'm standing in front of you today, I can't help but think how much I will miss all the memories and experiences that I've shared with my best friend throughout my time here at Donna Klein. 12 years seems like a lot, but it felt like no time at all. I want to thank my teachers who supported me throughout high school and helped me become the person I am today, especially Delmo and Lydia. And my best friends, since birth, kindergarten, fourth grade, and ones I've made throughout the years. Thank you for always making me laugh, being there for me, and making memories that will forever last. I don't know what I'll do without you guys. And my amazing family, Abba, Ima, Lior, Adi, Yuval, and Chewy. I love you guys more than you know, and I can't thank you enough for helping me, teaching me, and supporting me in everything that I do, including my decision of dropping to the IDF in November. I am beyond excited to begin this new chapter in my life in my favorite place in the world. I would like to wish the best of luck to all of the 2020 graduates in their plans after high school and the upcoming seniors as well. Thank you.
Dekel Dahoa.
Hello everyone, my name is Dekel and this is my graduation speech. I want to start off by thanking all the teachers who have helped me throughout my high school journey. Thank you to Maura Neumann for truly taking care of me when I broke my leg. Whenever I needed to lay down in her office, she would always allow me to. Thank you to Ms. Leibowitz for helping me with physics when I had Mr. Bowman. Next, I would like to thank Maura Lydia and Ms. Schuler for letting me eat my entire breakfast in their classroom each morning. Lastly, I want to thank my parents for always supporting me and teaching me to never give up. Abba, you are my role model and I will always admire how incredibly smart you are. Ima, thank you for everything. You have always been by my side, showing me I can do anything I dream of doing. I want to thank my sisters, Danielle and Lee. Danielle, you are so inspirational and taught me I can do anything I set my mind to. Lee, I want to thank you for always having my back and showing me that I will always have you by my side, no matter what happens in life. High school has been a blast, and I will never forget the memories I've made.
Lee Dahoa.
12 years later at Donna Klein Jewish Academy. The relief I feel delivering this speech is so surreal. Without Donna Klein, I would not be where I am today, as cliche as it sounds. I discovered that I am an artist. I would never have maintained my Hebrew so well. I wouldn't have learned so much about my Judaism, Israeli history, so on and so on. From the bottom of my heart, I would love to thank my second mothers, Ms. Neumann, Maura Lydia, and Ms. Schwartz. I don't know if I would have survived all these 4 years without your continued advice, guidance, support, and most of all, criticism to keep being my best self. Ima, thank you for being the super slash Wonder Woman that you are and showing me that nothing is impossible. Thank you for being my best friend, always keeping it real with me, no matter how harsh it may sound. Abba, thank you for always being so understanding and never failing to make me laugh. No one will ever forget the one day in AP Lane where you walked into class and yelled, "What is going on, everybody? What are we learning today?" Danielle, my role model. I can't explain to you how much I aspire to be even happy the woman that you will become. Your determination for success, no matter what is in your way, is beyond inspiring. Nobody understands how hard it is to live halfway across the world with you. Danielle, my roommate. I will forever cherish our love-hate relationship. Even though you get on each one of my nerves throughout my entire body, I love you forever and always will be there for you and be your best friend no matter what. Whatever we do in the future, I will always be by your side and continue to help you with whatever you need, even though sometimes it seems like I don't. Most of all, I would love to give a special shout-out to Quizlet, Chegg.com, Photomap, Shoot, SparkNotes, and my dog, Lex. Thank you all for sticking by my side all these years. Don't know if I would have been able to survive high school without you guys. In all seriousness, taking this with me on my journey outside of Donna Klein, I can't wait to make Aliyah back home and serve in the Israel Defense Forces, and then later attend the Interdisciplinary Center in Herzliya, Israel. Thank you.
Gil El-Karif.
Wow. We actually did it. I bet none of the teachers pictured me be on this stage today, graduating. DKJA has shaped me into the outgoing, loud, fun person that I am today. I am endlessly grateful for the opportunities and experience I gained at DKJA that have prepared me to embark on my future college career. From the endless conversation in Ms. Neumann's office to the complaining of the sudden work overload, from the loud random noises in the hallway to the vibrant classroom, I will genuinely miss the class of 2020. Professor Nelbo, what can I not say right now? You have been there for me through thick and thin and clutched up when I needed you most. I'm going to miss you and the short or long conversations that we have about anything and everything. It's grand of it. I really am going to miss you and miss interrupting you in class, making you laugh and you helping me with work, especially when the teachers decided to give us a lot of it. Now, on to my family. This might sound weird, but I'm unbelievably grateful for the amount of arguments I had with my family about school and about the way things should have been done. Eden and Shani, may you continue to always push me to my greatest potential and force me to do the things that I didn't realize would help me in the future. Shani, you thought I was done annoying you, but I'll see you in Gainesville next year. Eden, may I remain taller than you and better at FIFA. I love you guys. Last but not least, Ima and Abba. Thank you for always being there for me and supporting me, even though I have not always made the best decisions. You were always there for me and made sure I learned from every experience. I hope I keep making you proud. Guys, our time here together will not be remembered by our grades or what college we went to, but by our relationships and most likely the amount of trouble we caused. These are our legacies.
Shayna Goodis.
As I sit here writing my speech, I can't help but wonder how I got here. About 15 years ago, I was sitting on the top of a slide in my Donna Klein preschool classroom, getting ready to go down it for the first time. I gripped the top edges, positioned myself, and pushed forward, releasing myself down the slide. As I slid further and further down the slide, I increasingly became scared of the view in front of me, but then it all stopped and I realized I was safe. I guess you could say that's kind of how my high school career has been. I was nervous and timid, and then I decided to just go for it. I have been scared the entire time, and now it is stopping and the anxiety of high school has ended. I started at Donna Klein as a young Jewish girl who knew nothing about her journey ahead. There have been many bumps in the road, but ultimately Donna Klein will always be a home to me. This is where I grew up and this is where I learned who I am. Now, to Mrs. Joseph, Maura Neumann, Mrs. Delbo, and Mr. Bellotto, you four have helped me in many more ways than one. I look up to each one of you and just know that you will always have a special place in my heart. Mrs. Joseph, thank you for putting up with me. I know I'm not a typical student who abides by rules. I'll definitely miss hearing you say, "God help us all," as you yell at me for doing something stupid yet again. To my parents, David and Suzanne, you are the reason I'm here today and the reason I continue to grow as a person. I love you more and more each day. Lastly, to my brother Justin, thank you for bullying me out of all my weird phases. I love you, buddy. I've been at Donna Klein my entire life. I've seen the school change, people change, teachers change, but what hasn't changed is my heart, because this is where part of it will always be. Lastly, I just want to say that Jonah and I hosting Coffee House with Mr. Bellotto would have been groundbreakingly amazing, but I guess my jokes must remain unheard, and maybe that's a blessing. This isn't the end. It's my new beginning. Goodbye, Donna Klein. I might complain about you, but I think I know deep down I'll miss you. Thank you, and Shabbat Shalom.
For the faculty members of Rosenblatt High School, we all feel privileged to teach our students each and every day. Please enjoy some warm wishes from the faculty to the class of 2020.
I just want to say Mazal Tov to you guys. You know, you were my first class, seventh grade. I can never forget that class. You have a very sweet spot in my heart. I love you guys. I want to wish you the best of luck in all that you do in life. Be yourselves, shine your inner light forth, and make sure that you come back and visit us often. And we want to share in your simchas, all good things. We love you. Mazel Tov. Good Shabbos.
Guys, I'm making this recording from my home office, of course, and sad that we aren't all together in the usual way. But I want you to know that we've given you everything you need to navigate your way through this new reality. You have a sextant to show you how to find your way and a compass to help to direct you. The sextant are all of the skills that you've gotten in high school, and the compass is all of those great and wonderful lessons that you've learned here. So I wish you all the best, and know that you have everything you need to find your way to your dreams. The best of luck.
Congratulations, seniors. Wishing you all the luck and love as you go forward on your journeys in life. We'll miss you.
Oh, class of 2020, I'd like to wish all of you happiness and success and personal fulfillment as you grow intellectually, socially, and in terms of responsibility. All the best.
Congratulations to all of you in the class of 2020. I am so proud of each and every one of you for completing not just high school, but your college process with dedication and focus, even though I know it wasn't easy all the time. I am super excited for all of you to pursue your post-high school plans and to experience all that the world has to offer, all of the growth, all of the excitement. I wish you the best in everything that you do and a future filled with limitless possibilities. Mazal Tov, I love you all, and do not forget to come back and visit. Congratulations.
I just want to give a hearty congratulations to the class of 2020. Congratulations, graduates.
To the class of 2020, congratulations. Despite a literal pandemic, you've made it. And while you may be saying farewell to one saga in your life at Donna Klein, you're on the cusp of limitless opportunities. And perhaps the most exciting part about this is that life is truly what you and no one else is gonna make of it. So especially my Enviro seniors, remember where your food comes from, remember where your water comes from, and cut back on those long showers already. Congratulations.
Listen up, maggots. I got a little message for you. Congratulations graduating high school. I hope you're happy and content. All right, guys, for real, very happy for you all. I wish you nothing but the best in your life after high school, and your hard work and dedication has paid off, and here you are, graduated. I salute you all, and good luck.
Mazal Tov on your graduation, and I hope to see you soon to come and visit us.
Congratulations, class of 2020. This has been a momentous year for you and will be unforgettable in the story of your life. You've made a huge impact on our school, and we're really going to miss you. You're all moving on equipped with a top-notch education and the skills necessary to be your best self out there in the world. We have faith that you're going to go on and do wonderful things. Mazal Tov to all the students and families that have helped mold our graduates into the people that they are today. And always remember, live your life like a proton, positive, even when surrounded by negatives.
In a speech he gave in 1966, Robert F. Kennedy said, "There's a Chinese curse which says, may he live in interesting times. Like it or not, we live in interesting times. There are times of danger and uncertainty, but they are also more open to the creative energy of men than any other time in history." Those words ring true today. In the future, you will be telling your grandchildren about the pandemic and this turbulent time in history. Class of 2020, you are creative, resourceful, and resilient. As I look to our future, I know that everything will be all right because you will be the leaders of tomorrow. Sending lots of love and congratulations to you and your family. Mazal Tov.
Congratulations, you made it up to here. You were waiting for this moment for so many years, and here it is. I want to congratulate everybody. Some of you I know from fifth grade, from the advanced Hebrew class. Some of you I got to know in ninth grade. I had a wonderful time teaching you. And I want to wish you for the next stage in your life, as much as success that you had in high school. And also, I want to tell you, do good in school, reach out to others, and do kindness. So This is the time in your life that you are going to decide where you're going, what you're going to do with your future. And I know in advance that you are wonderful and you do very, very well. So good luck, guys. Remember, now you can befriend me on Facebook or Instagram, and I will know from your life and you will know from mine. So good luck to everybody. Congratulations. Yeshar Koach. And enjoy.
I want to congratulate all of our seniors at this special time in their lives. To a group of 14, I want to let you know I looked forward to and enjoyed the afternoons. No one class was ever the same. Remember DKJA class of 2020, as the unknown author of this quote states, success is never final and failure never fatal. It's courage and a positive attitude that counts. Succeed with your next chapter. Enjoy. Bye.
Hi guys, I have a secret to tell you. I'm gonna whisper it so you have to come close. You know what's the secret to happiness? It's praise. Yeah. Praising your friends is called compliments and blessings. Praising God is called prayer. If you do this every single day, before you know it, you'll be a happier person. So I want to bless you and wish you that you will continue praising God and praising your friends, and it will help you see the world with sacred eyes. It will make you happier, and you will make other people happier. So you have made us happy over the past 4 years, and we wish you success for the rest of your life. Please come back and tell us about your adventures. Leitraot.
Hi everyone, big Mazal Tov to the class of 2020. My heart is full of gratitude to have seen you grow into this amazing young woman and man that you are. I leave you with best wishes for much success and happiness in your future. I miss you all and I love you.
Okay, sorry, I must stay in character. You know me. Primero, felicitaciones a todos. Even to those of you who dropped Spanish, like after Spanish 2 or even 3, or never even wanted to take Spanish at all. Segundo, no olviden su español. Practíquenlo más y más y más. Tercero, no olviden los tiempos buenos que tuvimos. Las chicas Daniel, Renny y Batella, que siempre se reían secretamente. Los chicos Danny y Ben, que solo hablaban del tema de los deportes. Jonah, que siempre entendía todo lo que yo pensaba, porque es mi hermano secreto. Dekel, que comía y comía y comía, excepto cuando rompió la pierna. That's when we really knew something was wrong. Y Jaya, con su español verbal tan elocuente. Nunca los olvidaré. Les deseo mucho éxito en la vida. Son muy merecidos. And remember, video and Google Translate usually comes out all messed up, kind of like the subtitles in this video. But really, I do mean this. I will miss you all so very much. You're fabulous. I hope that you stay in touch with me, and I wish you all the best. Hasta luego.
To the class of 2020, Mazal Tov on your graduation and best wishes for the next adventures. We will miss you.
So this is my remark for you graduating seniors. It's amazing to see that you're finally going away from Donna Klein. But remember, success, it's getting what you want. And happiness is wanting what you want. So I'm going to leave you with this little bit of quote. Never give up on what you really want to do. A person with a big dream is more powerful than one with all the facts. Esther, go do your thing.
Hello, class of 2020. Congratulations on graduating, surviving 4 years of Rosenblatt High School. Whether I've had you in my classroom or coached you on the field or just passed you in the hallway, I wish you all the best of luck in your future. And again, congratulations. Be safe, be healthy, and good luck to all of you.
Mazal Tov, class of 2020. I wish you all the best on this new chapter. Congrats and good luck in college.
Hi, everybody. I just wanted to tell you I'm really going to miss you. I hope you look at the back of my house that says the drive on, and that you enjoy your graduation. You so deserve it. And this is a really special time. And as bleak as it can seem, you are going to have such memories that it's historic, you know? So anyway, good luck in all your endeavors. Bye.
Out of class of 2020, I wish you good health, happiness, and a lifetime of dreams come true on your life's journey.
Congratulations, class of 2020. I wish you all the best. I want to give a special congratulations to Michelle Nathanson, who was the first student this year to get into college from Donna Klein. Go Knights! Congratulations, Gil. I will miss your singing and your sense of humor. You will be a success in whatever you do. Leah Bard, your intelligence, grace, and kindness will get you far in life. Good luck at Tulane. Noah Bookstein, your art will forever stay on the walls of the dungeon. Go Noles, go Lions, go Canes, but never go Gators. Congratulations!
Shalom lachem seniors, bogrim yakarim ve'ahuvim. That's not how I planned to say goodbye. I would have come to each and one of you, give you a big hug, and wish you personally mazal tov ve'hatzlacha. I'm sending you my big hug virtually and wishing you all the best, great success, and fun in your next journey, either in college or any program in Israel or any place you wish to be at. I also want to say thanks to all of you for smiling and saying hi here and there. I want to say a big thank you to my Jewish Life members for running the holiday school activities in the most fun and successful way. And remember, a BMW can take you as far as a diploma. Please stay in touch. I'm always here for you. I love you all and proud of each and every one of you. Toda rabba, ohevet.
Hi, seniors. So you've surprised me 2 times in my life, and they're actually both almost the same kind of surprise. So the first, and I don't know if you remember this or not, or if I ever told you, but I subbed for you guys when you were in sixth grade. So I was teaching eighth grade, and the eighth grade kids were on the Israel trip, so I was available. And I think your teacher was sick, so I came in and I subbed for you. And I remember thinking, oh my God, sixth grade, what are they gonna be like? And I hadn't been 12 for a really long time, so I had no idea. And when I saw you, I was like, oh, they're so grown up. Then fast forward to the beginning of senior year, when I saw you guys that first day back, I was like, oh, they're so grown up. And some of them are so tall. So look, you guys are so lucky. I mean, not only are you the class of 2020, that's pretty cool, but you also hopefully are gonna be the only class in history who ended school virtually, you know, and who gets to do this whole weird, different graduation type of thing. It's definitely might be weird now, but it's gonna be something really cool to tell your kids and your grandkids. So have a great graduation. I'm sure you're gonna make the best of it. Have a lot of fun in college, be happy, and of course, come back and visit because you know that we love it.
Hey everybody. So just wanted to send a quick message and congratulate the entire class of 2020. I know this isn't the end of your high school career that you all wanted. It's definitely not the one you deserved, but I want you to know, and I think I can speak on behalf of everybody, how proud I am of all the things that you've done all year. So to the entire class of 2020, congratulations, and enjoy your college experience.
Okay, this is really weird for me to have to be saying goodbye to you guys in this format. I did put a picture of my office because that's where I feel at home with you all, since we spent the majority of time, or should I say, you spent the majority of time in my office eating dum-dums, taking my water, and doing all kinds of different things with my Zen sand, whatever. I am going to miss each and every single one of you. I am proud of each and every single one of you, and I know you will go on to forge your own unique path in this world, and I have no doubt that it's going to be special and it's going to be awesome. I really, really hope that you guys will come back and visit, even if you're thinking right now that you don't want to do that. I really hope that you change your mind, because I know that we will look forward to that, and I will have a new stash of dum-dums waiting for you. Congratulations, guys. I'm proud of you. Forge on with kindness and positivity, and I love you all.
To the class of 2020, what an incredible year this has been, and what an incredible ending. I wish you guys Mazal Tov, lots of luck. I know you're all going to be successful in everything that you do, even if you guys put every single gray head on my hair. I love you, and I'm going to miss you. Mazal Tov.
Ariel Huss.
My name is Ariel Huss, and I've been a student at Donna Klein Jewish Academy since I was a sophomore. Donna Klein's warm and nurturing environment helped me feel welcome and very quickly became my second family. I have made some amazing memories with great friends during these 3 years, and I will always cherish them and miss seeing you guys all the time. There are so many people who are responsible for helping me get here today. I would like to extend a special thank you to Ms. Feingold and Ms. Liebowitz for helping me fuel my love for science and medicine. Also, a special thank you to Ms. Joseph for her unwavering dedication to reviewing ACT math problems with me over and over until I was finally happy with my test scores. The one I want to thank the most, though, is the one person who isn't here today, but I know she is watching proudly from above. My Nana instilled in me the importance of a strong work ethic, the love of music, and the importance of upholding Jewish values and traditions. I'm sure she would be in the front row cheering me on today and excited to watch my path unfold. I hope to continue making her proud. To my grandparents, thank you for always supporting me, and especially to Saba Eni for your jokes and fun sense of humor. Most importantly, I'd like to thank my parents, who are always my biggest fans. I cannot thank you enough for raising me in such a loving and warm environment surrounded by family and friends. Thank you for not only being my parents, but my inspiration as well. Ima, thank you for all the efforts you made in helping me apply and get into college, and for guiding me every step of the way over the past 18 years to help me get to where I am today. Abba, thank you for teaching me perseverance and selflessness. Watching you put the needs of others above your own with such a strong work ethic makes you my greatest role model. Yonatan, you may be my little brother, but I still look up to you. You are definitely better than me at robotics and coding. Let's see how well you do in Ms. Lewis's chem class. I will miss you, not having you by my side every day. But please remember, I will always be here for you. For the next 4 years, I will be attending the University of Miami, studying health sciences and working hard to inch a few steps closer to my dream of becoming a physician. While I will miss Donna Klein in the years to come, I know it is time for my to spread my wings. Thank you, and go Hurricanes.
Talia Kadish.
Welcome, graduates, family, and faculty to the class of 2020's graduation. Congratulations, graduates. After 13 long years of hard work, we actually kind of finished. But this is not the end. Donna Klein and the community you have built here will be with you always, whether we're together or apart. Our journeys begin now, and it is up to you to take all the lessons you learned these past 13 years and put them into practice. I hope that the strong Jewish roots that you have grown here continue to flourish in all of your new lives. I'd like to thank Mr. Harris, for all of his guidance and efforts in helping me recognize my passion for math. Without his guidance, I wouldn't be where I am today in math. Mrs. Delbo, for always being there for all the students, and Ms. Joseph, for all the things you do. I don't know if I could even put into words how much you do for each individual student. I'd also like to thank my amazing family for guiding me to become the woman I am today. Seniors, I'm so sorry it had to end this way, but I can't wait to see the amazing things you'll do.
Jan Kasus.
First, congratulations to all the graduates and to your parents and families who are celebrating with you today and who will cheer you on to your next steps, which are coming fast. We did it and we all accomplished one of the early milestones of life, graduating high school. High school graduation is a major step in the journey of our lives and it should be recognized for its immense significance. It is an act not only of personal commitment, but also one of pride. We all worked hard to get to this day, and all of our work did not go to waste. A high school diploma is a wonderful tool in this world, and it is one that opens many doors of opportunity for anyone who is lucky enough to have one. However, graduation is not an end goal in itself. It is instead a part of the larger journey of life. Wherever your future takes you, let it take you somewhere. Life is a journey and all accomplishments we achieve during its course should be taken as starting points for further achievement. Our graduation should serve as such, a launching point projecting us to where our futures are meant to take us, whether we land ourselves a career or continue our education at another university. Before we can begin to reach the stars, there is one more personal milestone we all need to reach. Most people who graduate from high school experience only one graduation. However, we all have one more surely ahead of us. We've all already shown our commitment to personal growth through making it to the ceremony today. But soon, all of us will experience another ceremony when we graduate from our university. As I said before, life is a journey. We don't stop growing once we get our diplomas. Life is about growing and being and studying in our university. Gives each of us new opportunities to continue growing and to learn new skills that we will carry with us for the rest of our lives.
Maitar Megan.
Good evening. Thank you for being here to support the graduating class. I know this year isn't anywhere close to what we expected it to be, but we still made it. It's crazy to think I came into the school as a child and I'm now leaving as a young adult, ready to take on the next stage of my life. I want to thank my teachers and administrators who have helped me succeed and taught me throughout my high school experience. They taught me to believe in myself and strive for greatness. I would also like to thank my friends who have been there for me, and of course my family. Mama, Papa, Saba, Masafna, my aunts, uncles, cousins, and brothers, thank you for always having my back and always supporting me. Lastly, my parents who will do anything for me. Thank you for working so hard to raise me right with good morals and send me to the school so I can learn more about my Jewish heritage. I wouldn't be who I am today without you guys. Thank you from the bottom of my heart.
Jonah Manella.
Hello, everybody. My name is Jonah Manella, and I'm proud to be part of Yannick Klein Jewish Academy's graduating class of 2020. I'm a DKJ lifer, meaning I've attended the school since kindergarten. I've created many memories at the school, from learning how to read in kindergarten to suffering through all of my AP classes in high school. Throughout my time at DKJ, I've laughed, cried, and everything in between, but I wouldn't trade these experiences for anything. DKJ has helped mold my character and at the same time provided me with a well-rounded education. The skills that I've gained during my time as a Donna Klein student have helped prepare me for success in college and beyond. There are a few people I'd like to show my appreciation for. First off, I'd like to thank my mom, dad, and older sister, Gemma. These very special people in my life have been through thick and thin with me since the beginning. They've shaped me as a person and have taught me morals and values that I will take with me throughout my life. Second, I'd like to thank Mrs. Neumann for keeping me calm and steady during stressful times. I will never forget the talks we had in your office throughout my high school years. Last but certainly not least, I'd like to thank Mr. Bellotto for guiding me and being a mentor to me during high school. Your enthusiasm and knowledge of the subject has helped grow my passion for history stronger and possibly center my career around it. For the class of 2021, I have some advice for you. Enjoy every moment while it lasts, because time does go by too fast. To my fellow classmates and longtime friends, I hope you are successful in all of your future endeavors, and I'll always remember the good times you shared. As for myself, I'm excited to be attending the University of Central Florida for the next 4 years. Go Knights.
Kai Moran.
Hi, I'm Kai Moran. On one hand, I'm kind of happy to be here, and on the other, it's kind of sad. No more naps in the break room, no more varsity basketball with my friends, and no more being late to Mr. Bellotto's first period class. It's sad that we didn't get to finish our senior year as expected due to the virus, but I'm just thankful that I was able to graduate from home in my pajamas. I want to say a special thank you to Mom, Ava, Zach, and Jaden. Thank you, Mom, for waking me up every morning since I cannot wake up to an alarm, and thank you for always helping me achieve my goals. Zach, thank you for letting me continue the Moran legacy here at Donna Klein. Jaden, now it's your turn. Ava, thank you for always pushing me to be the best person I could be and always believing in me. Also, I want to thank my lifelong friends that I've made here in Donna Klein, and I'm sad to be separated from them next year. We finally graduated.
Graduates, please enjoy these special messages from your parents.
Hey, Rennie, congratulations on graduating. We're so proud of you and all the hard work you put in.
Yes, Rennie, we love you. We are proud of you. And UM awaits.
Have fun.
Yes.
Leah, today is the beginning of a whole new chapter in your life.
Lily, thank you for always teaching us and for being you. You amaze us every day and you're the light of our lives.
We are so proud of you and wish you congratulations on your high school graduation.
We love you, Leah.
Mazal Tov, you're the best.
Ilani, we are so proud of your strong work ethic, your Baalat Chesed, and your love of the Jewish way of life. Never stop learning, provide nothing but the best in the path you choose, and always surround yourself in positivity and goodness.
Our wish for you is that you take advantage of every door open to you to fulfill your mission with little stress and lots of opportunity for success.
And remember to always call your mom and dad.
Congratulations to the entire class of 2020.
And thank you, RHS, for your guidance, teachings, and warmth during these four fabulous years. Mazel Tov.
Sam, when we named you, it was with the hope that you would live up to the ideals of your ancestors and the Jewish people.
We see that today in you.
You have exceeded all of our expectations.
You are a young man of compassion, integrity, kindness, resourcefulness, creativity, and Menschlichkeit.
We are excited to see your continued growth in the coming years.
We are so proud of you, today and every day.
Mazel Tov!
Noah, Mazel Tov on your graduation from high school. We are so proud of you and excited to see what new adventures you will encounter as college beckons.
We have always been impressed with your love of learning, your intense curiosity, and engaging spirit. However, what stands out the most and will serve you well throughout life is your warm soul. You care deeply about people, about society, and the world we share today. When you see injustice, you speak up and look for equality.
You and the entire graduating class of 2020, some words of wisdom by the ultimate sage, Dr. Seuss. Why fill in when you are born to stand out? We love you so much, Noah. Live each day to its fullest and pursue all your dreams.
Daniele, we are very proud of you. It's been such a great journey here at DKJA with a lot of wonderful memories.
We wish you all the best in the Army. And I'm sure you're going to be a great example to your peers. You're going to be a lot of fun, and I'm sure you're going to have fun when you go to Israel.
Good luck, Danielle. Congratulations.
good luck in the Army and in Israel.
We're gonna miss you and we love you.
We love you.
We love you.
דקל וליה מקסימים, אבא, אימא, דניאל, כולנו, גאים בכם מאוד על סיום בית הספר התיכון, בהצלחה מרובה, על אף כל האתגרים והלימודים הקשים. כמו כן, אנחנו תומכים בכם בהחלטתכם המאתגרת, ללכת, להתגייס לצהל ולעשות עלייה. כל אתגר תומן בחובו צמיחה והצלחה. עלו והצליחו, אימא, אבא ודניאל האוהבים.
Declan and Lee, congratulations. You did it. You're graduating. Unbelievable. We are so very proud of you and so proud of the selfless path that you have chosen to take and volunteer to the IDF. We wish you lots and lots of wonderful experiences and may Hashem watch over you. Lechu l'shalom v'shuvu b'shalom. Ohavim etchem.
Mazal Tov Gil, you have reached a great milestone today.
We are so proud of you and all of your hard work. You have become such an amazing and young, handsome man.
Now you're off to a new chapter in your life. We are confident that you will thrive and make the most out of it.
We wish you a joyful and blissful future. Always follow your heart and be true to yourself. And we can't wait to see what the future holds for you.
We love you!
Sheena Goodis, congratulations on your graduation. We love you and we are so proud of you.
But here's the thing, it is a pandemic, so we have to be careful. Social distancing, we can't come too close. We can't come to college with you. We can't set up, we can't come visit you. You might be able to come home if you're not around anyone that's infected, but you know, we love you and we're very proud of you.
Good luck in college, we love you.
Mazal Tov, Ariel.
And Mazal Tov to all the graduates.
We watched you take your first steps, and now we watch you reach this milestone. We know you are ready to take the next big step.
We're immensely proud of your accomplishments and how hard you've worked, and even more proud of the young man you have become.
We wish you the best of luck at the University of Miami. Continue working hard and you will always achieve your goals. And remember, we are always behind you every step of the way. Congratulations!
We love you!
Hi, Ib! Where are you? Come!
What do you want now, honey?
It's Talia's graduation. We need to make a speech.
We do? Hang on, let's video it. Hang on a second, I'll switch it on. Hang on.
It's already on.
Are you sure, honey? I don't know if it's on. Hang on. I got this. Oh, okay, here we go.
Hi, Talia, this is especially for you. We just wanted to say you're an amazing daughter. We love you very, very much. You've achieved so much, so many APs that you've done. I think you were crazy, but I think you did fantastically well. We are very, very proud of you.
Congratulations, Talia. You make me so proud. We are so pleased that you got into the University of Miami. We cannot wait for you to start your year. We're sure you're going to have an absolute ball. I am very sorry that I tell all my friends about your amazing achievements. Go Canes!
And we love you.
Hello, Jan. Congrats on being a high school grad. I just can't help but think it was 18 years ago when you were just born. I was holding you in my arms for the first time and I whispered in your ear who you are. I gave you your Hebrew name and I told you you were a son of Israel. And I blessed you to grow up with education, with strong morals, Jewish identity, and you did it. That's how you grew up and that's who you are. And I'm so proud of you for that. And now you're off to college to fulfill the rest of your destiny. And I can't wait to see what you become and how you go about it. I wish you the best. Please keep me involved in everything that you do and how you do it. And I wish the best for you, Jan. I love you.
Congratulations, Maytar. Hope you have a great time next year. We're gonna miss you.
Have fun in college, man.
So proud of you for all your amazing achievements. I know you're gonna do great. I love you, proud of you. And I'm always there for you.
I'll see you next year in college, Connor.
Congratulations!
Can we make a video for me?
Congratulations to our smart, talented, charming, lovable, sometimes too loud, always hilarious Jonah. You can achieve all that you want in life if you follow this simple two-step recipe. Number one, believe in yourself as we believe in you. And number two, always follow that big heart of yours. Dad, Gemma, and I are so very proud of you, and we love you more than you'll ever know.
Hi Kai, here we are on your graduation. Obviously not quite the way we expected it to be, but anyway, you did it. You're graduating tonight. I love you. I can't wait to see what the future holds for you.
What's up Kai? Congratulations. Hope to see what you're gonna do in the future. Peace out.
Mazal Tov on your graduation, Badella. We're so proud of you. You've worked super hard to reach this day, and it's been a privilege and an honor to be your mom. I love you.
Congrats, Badella. Very proud of you and all of the work and time that you've put into making it and completing your high school career. And I'm looking forward to hearing about Denver and all of your future successes and endeavors. Love you.
We love you and wish the most amount of success possible for all your future endeavors. And we know you will succeed in anything that you do.
Love you.
Hi, class of 2020. Hi, Mira. Dad and I would like to congratulate you for everything you've accomplished so far. We are so proud of the woman you've become. You're beautiful on the inside and out.
We can't wait to see what the future holds in store for you. I know you'll always continue to work hard, but I hope you will always also learn to play very hard. We love you very much.
I hope you enjoyed our cameo video.
Danny, we're so proud of you and watching you grow over the years and grow and grow.
Okay.
And grow. We're going to need a new house.
Danny, we are very proud of you. It's been such an incredible experience for Dad and I to have you and raise you to this point. You have been an amazing role model for your brothers, and we just can't wait to see what life has to offer for you going forward. So we're excited for this next chapter. Congratulations to the entire class of 2020. We love you.
We love you.
Daniela, we want you to know how proud you have made us.
We are so thankful each and every day that you are part of our lives.
There is a bright future ahead with many new opportunities waiting just for you.
Go with confidence in the direction of your dreams and live the life you imagined.
All your dreams can come true if you've got the courage to pursue them.
Believe in you.
Love you.
Up in the air.
Around the world.
And in our hearts.
Hi, friends and family. Hi, Daniela. Greetings from Bollinger Shipyard in Port Fouchon, Louisiana. So, Danny, congratulations. I know this day has finally come. I'm very happy for you. I'm very proud of you. I only have 30 seconds to talk, so just know I love you very much, and I'll be seeing you soon.
Danny, congratulations. Yay, you did it. You graduated high school. I wish that I could be there to witness this special day and to give you a proper celebration. Just know that I miss you and I love you and I think about you every day. I'm so incredibly proud of you. I can't wait to see what the future has in store for you. I wish you nothing but happiness and success in your future endeavors. Sending my love all the way from Guam. Congratulations, Mama. You did it.
My beautiful, Kaya, my baby, I'm so proud of you. It has been an amazing experience seeing you growing up and working and learning and accomplishing all this challenges in your life. I love you so much. I'm so proud of you. I know you're gonna make a difference in this world. You have all the power. You are a good leader, a good friend. I know you can see through a lot of details in people and personalities, and you can read away and beyond problems and situations. You want to make a difference, my beautiful daughter. I love you, and I'm really waiting. So happy to see your next challenges and your next accomplishments. And thank you to the school staff, the donors, to everybody that were part of your team, the school, or this 2020 graduation team. Mazal Tov to everybody. I wish everything, all the best for everybody. Thank you, and I love you all. I wish all the best again, many, many simpas and smiles. All the best. Love you.
Thank you, Hashem, for the wonderful opportunity of having my daughter, Haya, in that wonderful school with the best faculty, teachers, and administrations there are. And to you, my beloved daughter and class 2020, who have the highest challenges in modern history, but you have all the gear, the human values, and everything that is required to be successful. I love you and bless you to do the best you can do.
We are so proud of you. You have blown us away every single day for the past 18 years. You are always willing and ready to learn and are respectful and very, very open-minded and flexible. Thank you so much for everything you've taught me these past 18 years. And I also want to thank Donna Klein for preparing you for the future. I'm sure it will be bright and filled with success. And remember that when you don't feel so successful, it's all part of the process. And you'll get far. You'll get very far because we will always be cheering you on.
Ben, everything your mom just said, I echo everything. And there's not even much I can add to that because we do learn from you so much every day. We love you so much. We are so proud of you. And we also do want to definitely thank Donna Klein for everything they've done for you, the administration, the faculty, teachers,
coaches.
It's been an incredible experience, and we are so happy that you, how much we've seen you mature over these last, I will say specifically your high school 4 years, but your entire time that you've been at Donna Klein. It's an amazing place. We're so glad that you were able to experience it, and we look forward to what's in store for you in your future. And we hope you'll come back and visit us a lot.
Love you.
Bat Ella Pesa.
After attending DKJA for practically my whole childhood, I turned 13 and it was time for me to think where I wanted to go to high school. When thinking about where I was going to go, I wound up choosing to leave and try a new experience. After attending North Broward for freshman and sophomore year, I began to realize as much as I grew as a person, I needed to come back to my DKJ family. The past 2 years have definitely not gone how I would have ever imagined, but I'm so thankful for all the support Donna Klein has given me. A special thank you to Ms. Joseph for having my back even when I didn't make it easy. While I have grown a lot, I have also made just a few mistakes. So just a little advice, do not skip tefillah. If you do skip tefillah, make sure that all your friends are fast runners so you don't get caught. Also, if you ever want to make a TikTok in school, don't. Make sure to enjoy every day as much as possible, because no matter how much you say that you can't wait for high school to be over, the truth is that it goes by so fast. So make sure to make the best memories. I could not be more grateful for the friendships I formed at Donna Klein, and that is truly the hardest part about leaving. Thank you to my best friends for being there for me through everything and always messing around with me. Thank you to my teachers for putting up with me in classes, especially when I'm sitting next to one of my friends. There is one person in school I do not think I could have got through my classes without, and that is Ms. Delvo. Thank you for always having your office open, even when you get in trouble for it. Last, but definitely the most important, I want to thank my parents and brother for always being the people I can lean on and trust. Thank you for all the love and support you have given me and continue to give me every day. While I definitely will miss you through next year, I'm very excited to attend the University of Denver next year. And I know that Yossi is looking down so proud of me, not only for actually graduating high school, but for getting into college.
Mira Vrudensky.
When I initially decided to switch schools, I was nervous. It was a huge change for me. Had I come from a big school with hundreds of people in my grade alone to a grade of barely 30, I wasn't sure whether it was worth it. But I knew the fact that I couldn't really partake in any activities at Dreyfus as a Sabbath observant Jew was grating on me and would only get worse as I became an upperclassman. So I decided to switch, and I'm immensely grateful I did. Donna Klein has been so kind to me. They nurtured me from the moment I stepped onto campus that first day of junior year, guiding me and helping me in all that I've achieved in the short time I've been here. I'd especially like to thank Ms. Rothman, who's an absolute treasure and was so helpful as I began testing and applying to college. I can't even think of one teacher to thank because they've all been so wonderful and warm whenever I needed help with a last-minute recommendation letter, a plug, or even a side project that had absolutely nothing to do with school. Lastly, I'd like to thank my parents for sticking with me and allowing me to grow at my own pace, for being supportive when I wanted to leave the yeshiva system and go to Dreyfus, and for being supportive when I decided Dreyfus couldn't provide me with everything I needed. I truly would never have been able to achieve anything without your support and your respect of my decisions. I'm grateful to be attending Brown University next year. I know I would not have been able to achieve this without the help of DKJA, and I know that the confidence I've gained here will not only help me through college, but follow me wherever I go for the rest of my life.
Danny Siemens.
Wow. 13 years later, and it's all over. Although there were plenty of rough times, it turned out that Donna Klein was one of the best decisions of my life. Ever since I visited the high school for the first time and witnessed the family-like feel that I'd always heard about, I knew that this was the place I'd be able to succeed most. The ability to make friends from every grade and build strong bonds with the teachers was something that I couldn't find at any other school. Donna Klein helped me become the person I am today, both in the classroom and on the court. It helped me develop my overall character and aspects that I thought that I couldn't. Donna Klein has most definitely shaped me to become ready for the next chapter of my life, and I appreciate everyone who has helped me get to this point. None of this would have been possible without you guys. First, I'd like to thank all my teachers. They made sure I was always dedicated to my education and pushed me out of my comfort zone. Next, I would like to thank all my coaches. I appreciate all of you, but I want to especially thank Mr. Bellotto. You took me in as a freshman trying out for the football team and helped me grow as a person more than you know. It was a long journey, but you mentored me and helped me become the leader I needed to be. To the class of 2020, I want to thank you for all the friendships that I've made in these 4 years. I can't even imagine what my life would be like without you guys. Last but not least, to my parents. I want to thank you guys for pushing me to strive in both my academics and athletics. It was hard at times, but it was all worth it in the end. Thank you all, and go Gators.
Daniela Sapovitz.
Tonight ends my official Jewish education through Donna Klein. 13 years later, I honestly thought this day would never come, but now that it's here, I'm able to look back on all the wonderful experiences, opportunities, and memories Donna Klein has given me. One of my highlights has been being a part of the DKJA drama department and being given so many amazing leadership opportunities within the program. I know from the bottom of my heart that I wouldn't have a chance to excel within the performing arts without the love, care, and community that the drama department provided for me. Along with that, I'm excited to say that I will be continuing my theater studies in college, along with going on a pre-law track as well. Even though both majors may seem very different, they are actually more similar than you think, and I am super excited to start this new chapter in my life. To finish off, I would like to conclude with some thank yous. To my parents, thank you for always believing in me and putting all your time and effort into my schooling and my theater while raising me to become the person I am today. Maxwell, thank you for not just being my brother, but being my best friend. Even though you were up at UCF most of the year, you still never failed to be there for me in times of need. To my eldest brother, Brian, I know how badly you wanted to be here for my graduation today, but due to the circumstances of Corona, sadly you couldn't. I want to thank you for not only being the person I look up to, but for serving in the Coast Guard and keeping our country safer for the past 13 years. You're truly a remarkable person. Lastly, I would like to thank the Donovan faculty for always being there for me the past 13 years and for helping me get to where I am today. Thank you.
Chaya Trachtenberg.
First and foremost, I'd like to start off my speech by saying this has been a long road. Thank you to everybody who has helped me succeed. It only consists of moving back and forth 12 times to 3 different countries. Throughout this journey, I had a number of fans cheering me on along the way. My family, who I owe everything to, especially my siblings, who I promised a special thank you in my speech after they said they'd never talk to me again if I didn't. So here it goes. To David and Devorah, thank you for your constant encouragement and believing in my abilities to succeed. To my own personal grandmother, Ruthie, thank you for being my personal tutor throughout high school. To Rebecca for teaching me how to enjoy life. To Joseph, who taught me not to take slack from people. To Michael, who taught me que más sabe el diablo por viejo que por diablo. To Papi, thank you for always going to my parent-teacher conferences, even after telling you you don't need to go. To Mommy, gracias, gracias, gracias. And to the Donna Klein staff, to Ms. Delbo, who served as my rock for 4 years, Mr. Bellotto, who I could always trust to push me on the soccer field, Dr. Estivo, hashtag junior year forever, Silvina, eres lo máximo, Ms. Neumann, thank you for the crackers, and to the rest of the Donna Klein staff, who helped me pave my way to success. I couldn't have gotten here without you, and each and every one of you.
Ben Zuner.
Good afternoon. A little over 12 years ago, I was 6 years old, and it was my first day at Donna Klein Jewish Academy. I remember being sent off on the first day, scared of what the future would hold, and most importantly, if I was going to make friends. I have made incredible bonds with my peers at Donna Klein, and I know the friendships will last a lifetime. Donna Klein has been a great home for me for the past 13 years. Although I'm sad to leave, I'm also excited to see what the future holds. Senior year was not how any of us envisioned it. During the middle of the second semester, all schools were shut down in the state of Florida. This last stretch was supposed to be a time where my class and I were going to bond for one last time. We were supposed to go on a life-changing trip to the March of the Living, prom got canceled, and we didn't even know if we were going to have graduation. I'm proud to say that even though all this happened, like we always do, my grade made the most out of our time left and did what we could to enjoy these last couple weeks. I would like to thank a couple of people for making my high school year so great. First, I would like to thank all of my teachers for not only teaching me during these past 4 years, but helping shape who I am today. Ms. Joseph, thank you for making your math class almost impossible in 10th and 11th grade. Seriously, it taught me how to really put the extra work in and become the student I am now. Ms. Neumann, thank you for always being there for me, even when you came in the morning before Rosh Hashanah to proctor the ACT. Ms. Adams, thank you for giving me opportunities I never knew I had in the drama department. Josh, Mia, and Joseph, even though you might not believe me, I'm really going to miss you guys next year. During quarantine, we really got a lot of time to connect and spend more time with each other, and I'm going to miss seeing you guys every day. Lastly, I would like to thank my parents. Even when I had my struggles in high school, you guys never gave up on me, and I would definitely not be on this stage without your support. Thank you for not only instilling me with a strong passion for learning, but also with strong passions for kindness, compassion, and many more. Juniors, it is hard to be a senior. There are a lot of parts when you do not want to do the extra essay or that history test. You guys will get through it, and I wish you the best of luck. Thank you all, and go Hoosiers.
יחד לב אל לב נפתח ונראה את האור שבשמיים יחד לב אל לב נפתח בתקווה לאהבה
איך שהלב נפתח חובק את העולם Thank you.
please welcome Talia Klein, co-president of the Board of Trustees.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Talia Klein, and I am co-president, along with Shari Heyer, of the Donna Klein Jewish Academy Board of Trustees. On behalf of the board, I am sincerely honored to welcome you to the 2020 Momentous Driving Graduation Ceremony of the Claire and Emmanuel G. Rosenblatt High School. The seniors who are graduating today are each accomplished in their own unique way, whether it be academically, athletically, artistically, spiritually, or all of the above. Over the past few months, under unusual circumstances, each one of you has had to become resilient, adaptable, and courageous, all qualities along with the exemplary academic education you received at DKJA that it will help you face the next chapter in your lives. Students at DKJA are taught and mentored by individuals who help them acquire the skills and knowledge which will enable them to have successful and productive lives. I would like to take a moment to thank our exceptional faculty and administrators. Our faculty are not only scholars in their academic fields, but aspiring individuals with passion for what they do and truly care for each individual student. This is clearly evident in their determination to ensure that each one of you feels the love, pride, and belonging in the way you are celebrated as an integral part of DKJA. You are invaluable role models, and the Board of Trustees thank you for your dedication and hard work. I would also like to take a moment to thank the parents who are here this evening. You have given your children an extraordinary opportunity to learn much more than a typical academic high school education. Throughout their years at DKJA, these graduates have learned how to live in the world and to make it a better place through Tikkun Olam and Jewish continuity. Shari and I have three DKJA graduates between us. And take it from us, your children are extremely well prepared to thrive in college and beyond. Congratulations to the graduating class of 2020. You have demonstrated through your performance, both in and out of the classroom, that you are caring, hardworking, risk-takers who are committed to Judaism and to Israel. You have a formidable foundation to move forward and take on the world that awaits you. Kol hakavod and Mazal Tov.
We want to take a moment to recognize all of the award winners from this year's senior class. The Danielle Tzfat Award for Outstanding Achievement in 2D Design, Meitar Megan. The Danielle Tzfat Award for Outstanding Achievement in Theater Arts, Ben Zuner and Michelle Nathanson. The Dr. Abraham and Nana Hamoui Award for Outstanding Achievement in Innovations in Science and Engineering, Noah Bookstein. The Fanny and Isaac Sherman Award for Outstanding Torah Achievement, established by Rose and Saul Turetsky, Leah Bard. The Jean Rozevsky Buckman and Nathan Buckman Outstanding Achievement Award in Art, Lee Dehoa. The Karen Feller Award for Outstanding Achievement in Leadership, Gil El-Karif. The Linda Rosenblatt Kamenow Award for Outstanding Achievement in English, Mira Rudensky. The Linda Rosenblatt Kamenow Award for Outstanding Achievement in Hebrew, Lee Dehoa. The Maurice and Dorothy Halpern Family Award for Outstanding Achievement in History, Sam Bernstein. The Nathan and Jean Buckman Charles Okun Award for Outstanding Achievement in Science, Ariel Huss and Ilanit Berkauer. The Ruach Award, Gil El-Karif. The Heather and Max Millard Award for Outstanding Achievement in Writing, Mira Rudensky. The Linda Halpern Klaus and Barry Minkin Endowment Award for Outstanding Achievement in the Arts, Daniela Sapovitz. The Sandelman Family Award for Outstanding Achievement in Mathematics, Talia Kadish. The Spooner Family Athletic Endowment Award, Daniel Siemens. the Golden Eagle Award, Gil El Karif, and last, the Community Service Award. This is outstanding achievement in community service, meaning more than 500 hours during high school. Leah Bard, Danielle Chacham, Dekel Dehoa, Lee Dehoa, Gil El Karif, and Maitar Megan. Congratulations to these outstanding members of this year's senior class. Please welcome Assistant Principal Mrs. Ilana Joseph, who will now present this year's Halevi Award.
The Abraham Halevi Award was established by Eric and Lauren Stein in blessed memory of Eric's father, Alan Stein, Abraham Ben Yosef Halevi. The Halevi Award was created and awarded to its first recipient during DKJA's first high school graduation and has become a tradition at each graduation since. The award is very special to not only me, but to the entire Rosenland High School community. Not only because of the incredible students who have been chosen, but also because of what the award itself symbolizes and the expectations of which the award winner must uphold. This award represents the embodiment of character and attributes of Abraham Ben Yosef Halevi, and in turn is awarded each year to a graduating senior who does the same. Past recipients and tonight's recipients exemplify the following criteria: excels academically in both secular and Judaic studies, leads his or her peers by example, shows strong Jewish values, including Derek Aarons and the love of the people of and the land of Israel, has integrity, morality, maturity, and sensitivity, has graciousness and generosity of spirit, time, and resources, knows how to be a good friend and to maintain confidences, and will attend a four-year bachelor degree program at an accredited college or university. In addition, there are expectations of the recipients, and they are as follows. The recipient will receive a grant for use towards improving themselves, their future, or their community. The grant will be paid out in four annual installments and requires the recipient to return to DKJA each of those years to spend time with the graduating class and other students. This year, Halevi Award winners are equally qualified as award winners of this prestigious award. Both students have met all their requirements as well as brought forth their own unique talents and genuinely caring Jewish spirit to contribute to Rosenblatt High School's community at large. This year's Abraham Halevi Award winners are Leah Bard and Ilan Yudberghauer. Leah has shown consistent and dedicated passion for service. In middle school, Leah and a classmate developed an outreach program to address the needs of the flood victims in Colorado. This was an early indicator of the kind of impact Leah can and has made at DKJA. Leah continues her commitment to serving people of all ages. She's a weekly volunteer at the Folk Center for Counseling's Generation to Generation program. She also volunteers with the Yachad program, which provides interactive social opportunities for teens and developmentally disabled adults. She's actively involved with NCSY and is a leader within the local chapter and the board. Last year, Leah was accepted to the Center for Israel Education Team Leadership Institute at Emory University. Through this selective program, she broadened her knowledge of Israel and learned to teach others in the Jewish community about the country. In school, Leah serves as a role model through her work as editor-in-chief of the school yearbook and the ADL No Place for Hate Club, among others. Lastly, Leah was instrumental in bringing a local chapter of UMatter to our school. She was a UMatter board member and helped coordinate events, facilitate speakers, and recruit participants for this organization. This organization creates a safe environment for teens to discuss mental health issues and also promotes suicide prevention awareness. Leah's endless hours of meaningful community service tell us exactly the kind and caring and giving person she is, and serve to make her a wonderful representative of the Halevi Award. Mazal Tov, Leah. Ilanit. Ilanit came to the high school with a great spirit of caring and leadership. She embodies a commitment to academic excellence and for Derek Aarons, acting with the utmost respect for her peers and adults alike. Elena plans to pursue a career in the field of medicine, and she has immersed herself in the opportunities that feed her passion. She has participated in a gene therapy research project for the last 2 years, and she's an active long-term member volunteer at both Broward Hospital and the West Boca Medical Center. She serves as the president of our pre-med club this year and was previously coordinator, organizing a diversity of educational and experiential options for the students. She even expanded the club repertoire to include CPR and AED training and certification for all of its participants. Elinette is the president of the school's APEC and JNF chapters, and she serves as a mentor in the Jewish-oriented business club, as well as other Jewish life, Israel awareness clubs and activities. Elinette shares her passion for piano by playing for the elderly in local nursing homes and hospitals. She is a role model who will contribute to the Jewish community long after her graduation from Dana Klein Jewish Academy.
Please welcome Rabbi Baruch Plotkin, Rabbi in Residence, who will now give the benediction to the senior class.
Our God and God of our forefathers and foremothers, we invoke your blessing upon all who are gathered here today to witness the graduation of the Claire and Emmanuel Rosenblatt High School at Dana Klein Jewish Academy. Today we take delight in the realization that a blessed group of our next generation have, with conscientious devotion and praiseworthy distinction, diligently pursued and successfully completed their course studies here in our school. We pray that as a result of the knowledge they have acquired, they may be inspired to uphold with courage, pride, and dignity the eternal teachings of our Torah and the immortal ideals of our faith. May they continue to drink and joy from the living waters of our heritage in the years that lie ahead, thereby enriching themselves, their families, our community, and contributing to a better world. Yisha Berach Avoteinu Avraham Yitzchak Yaakov Sarah Rivka Rachel Vileya Hu Yivarech Et Kol HaKahal HaKadosh Hazeh Im Kol Kehilot HaKodesh Heim unasehem uvenehem uvenotehem v'kol ashelahem Umi shemachadim batei sefer lilmot ulameid Umi shevarim betocham litpalel Umi shenotnim ne'el ma'or v'yayin l'kiddush v'l'havdalah U'pat l'orchim u'tzedakah l'anim V'chol mi shoskim betzarchei tzibur be'emunah HaKadosh Baruch Hu Yishalem Zcharam Vayasya Mehem Kol Machala Vayirpa Lechol Gufam Vayishlach Lechol Avonam Vayishlach Bracha Vehatzlacha Vehol Maaseh Yadehem Im Kol Yisrael Achehem V'nomar Amen.
Please welcome the head of school of Dana Klein Jewish Academy, Mrs. Elena Levine.
Isn't it strange how princes and kings and clowns that caper in sawdust rings and common people like you and me are builders for eternity? Each is given a list of rules, a shapeless mass, a bag of tools. And each must fashion where life is flown, a stumbling block or a stepping stone. I am delighted to welcome the graduating class of 2020 this evening. I want to also extend a heartfelt welcome and thanks to all who have joined us here today. I am especially proud to address our Rosenblatt High School graduates, your families, your circles of friends, and your dedicated school and community members. The DKJA family is a unique one, and this year we have faced unique challenges and opportunities. In 1890, Georgia-born R.L. Sharp wrote a poem entitled, A Bag of Tools, and its message and meaning are particularly applicable today. Sharp suggests that all individuals carry and fill their tool bags as they create and manifest their own destinies. Each symbolic bag is uniquely filled and designed by each one of us, and each person uses his or her bag to help build a future of stepping stones or stumbling blocks. In vivid poetic lines, Sharp succeeds in drawing a universal picture of growth, opportunity, and realizing our dreams. This year, we have faced a stumbling block of historic proportion, and all of us have experienced the reverberations of this pandemic, but our talented graduates have found unique ways to grow and to flourish within our society's new rules and directives. Graduates, you have achieved socially, academically, and emotionally. Your college acceptance letters and passion and purpose for the land of Israel are testimonies to your dedication and pursuit for everything we wish for you. Your broad smiles have inspired both your classmates and teachers to truly acknowledge the value of shared instruction and animated discourse, and we are proud of your investment in learning and laughter. All of you display a true sense of camaraderie. Most importantly, you have turned a stumbling block into a stepping stone of growing maturity, expanding imagination, and lasting friendships. Adversity has neither slowed you nor forfeited your dreams. Each of you has expanded your tool bag with special memories and many moments. Each of you carries a strong moral compass built upon an indestructible lining of Jewish values and traditions. Each of you has added a weave of educationally and socially shared experiences and community-based projects to your impressive record. These unique times have inevitably expanded your love for family and friends, and we are confident that your self-confidence and self-respect are firmly tucked into your forever mats. You are vibrant, thoughtful, and energetic individuals who will choose career paths that realize your personal dreams and contribute to our wonderful world. Your smiles of optimism are the keys to a bright future of productivity and delight. DKJA's dedicated staff and professionals know that each of our graduates recognizes the importance of hard work, true effort, dignity, and hard-earned success. Thank you to our wonderful teachers for helping our students to navigate each stepping stone this graduating day. Thank you to our wonderful families for guiding our graduates to each stepping stone of strong family values and Jewish tradition. Thank you to our DKJA community for encouraging our students to step into their futures with a realistic and collaborative purpose. Thank you, above all, to our graduating class of 2020 for your eager ability to adapt to change with resiliency, flexibility, and candor. We welcome you tonight as members of our proud DKJA alum. We love you, and we are so proud of each and every one of you. Mazel tovs to you and to your families.